Our presider is Reverend Father Marlon Reyes, SSS. Please stand.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings He bears to those who trust in His grace. We, the daughters and sons of Him, who build the valleys and our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings He bears to those who trust in His ways. In His wisdom, He strengthens us like gold has tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to stand. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings He bears to those who trust in His ways.
We begin our thanksgiving in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us lift up to God our thanksgiving for the many blessings that we have received. Let us prepare our hearts to receive Jesus. Let us also acknowledge our sinfulness. We remember the many times we have offended God and the many times we have hurt others. With a humble heart, we ask the Lord for His pardon and mercy. We humbly say, I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Let us pray. By your help, we beseech you, Lord our God, may we walk eagerly in that same charity with which, out of love for the world, your Son handed Himself over to death. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, who opens a way in the sea and a path in the mighty waters, who leads out chariots and horsemen, a powerful army, till they lie prostrate together, never to rise, is snuffed out and quenched like a weak. Remember not the events of the past, the things of long ago consider not. See, I am doing something new. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? In the desert I make a way, in the wasteland rivers. Wild beasts honor me, jackals and ostriches, for I put water in the desert and rivers in the wasteland, for my chosen people to drink, the people whom I form for myself, that they might announce my praise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glad indeed. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I consider everything as a loss because of the supreme good of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. For his sake, I have accepted the loss of all things, and I consider them so much rubbish, that I may gain Christ and be found in him. Not having any righteousness of my own based on the law, but that which comes through faith in Christ, the righteousness from God, depending on faith to know him and the power of his resurrection and the sharing of his sufferings by being conformed to his death, if somehow I may attain the resurrection from the dead. It is not that I have already taken hold of it, or have already attained perfect maturity, but I continue my pursuit in hope that I may possess it, since I have indeed been taken possession of by Christ Jesus. Brothers and sisters, I, for my part, do not consider myself to have taken possession. Just one thing, forgetting what lies behind but straining forward to what lies ahead, I continue my pursuit toward the goal, the prize of God's upward calling in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, for I am gracious and merciful.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went to the Mount of Olives, but early in the morning he arrived again in the temple area, and all the people started coming to him, and he sat down and taught them. Then the scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery and made her stand in the middle. They said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. Now in the law, Moses commanded us to stone such women. So what do you say?" They said this to test him, so that they could have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and began to write on the ground with his finger. But when they continued asking him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let the one among you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her. Again, he bent down and wrote on the ground. And in response, they went away, one by one, beginning with the elders. So he was left alone with the woman before him. Then Jesus straightened up and said to her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She replied, "No one, sir." Then Jesus said, "Neither do I condemn you. Go, and from now on, do not sin anymore." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. We are now on the fifth Sunday of Lent. Tayo po ay unti-unti nang pumapasok sa mga mahal na araw. Next week, Holy Week na. Meron akong tanong. Why do gorillas have big nose trills? Bakit malaki ang butas ng ilong ng mga gorilla? Why? Because they have big fingers. Nabasa ko lang yun. In our gospel for today, fingers do a lot of talking. On one hand, are the accusing fingers, of the scribes and the Pharisees, pointed toward a woman caught in adultery. And on the other is the exonerating finger of Jesus writing on the ground. Ang mga daliri ng Pariseo at Saduceo nag-aakusa. Ang mga daliri ni Jesus nagsusulat, nakaturo sa lupa, writing on the ground. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, I invite you to take a look at your hands. Do you have accusing, condemning fingers? Do you have dirty hands? Dirty hands that grab. Dirty hands that steal. Dirty hands that hurt. And often, turn into a clenched fist in anger. Or do you have a welcoming, pardoning, and approving fingers? Ano ang sinasabi ng inyong mga kamay at daliri sa inyong pagkatao? Do you have clean hands that share, reach out, and console? And often folded before God in prayer. Your fingers, your hands, says a lot. May sinasabi ang mga kamay at daliri natin sa ating pagkatao. Some people, they spend their whole lifetime pointing at themselves. Mayroong mga tao, sa buhay nila, nakaturo lamang lagi ang mga daliri sa sarili. Ako to, ako yan, ako ganun. Only to realize in the end how empty and vain the whole exercise was, mga taong puro sila lang, puro sarili lang ang iniisip, puro sarili lang ang mahalaga, puro sarili lang ang tama, puro sarili lang ang magaling. As we go through life, my dear brothers and sisters, may we also point at something or someone greater than us. Maraming bagay na mabuti at maganda maliban sa ating sarili. Some people spend their whole lifetime grabbing, hoarding so many earthly wealth and honors, only to realize in the end how pointless and burdensome it all was. Lalo na mga taong mayayabang, parang walang kapaguran sa pagturo lang ng sarili para ipagyabang ang sarili. In the end, sino ang mapapagod? Yung tao ding nagyayabang. You know, the better thing to do is we go through life with open hands that gratefully receive and generously share and give. Ganito ang dapat maging ugali ng ating mga daliri at kamay. We gratefully receive and we generously share and give. We do not know what Jesus wrote on the ground. Hindi nakasulat sa Biblia kung ano yung isinulat ni Jesus doon sa lupa, doon sa alikabok. But the picture of Jesus pointing to the ground was in itself very symbolic. It was Jesus' way of reminding the proud and the arrogant and the self-righteous. Jesus is reminding them of their mortality. And Lent, my dear brothers and sisters, is really a very special time of the year. We are reminded that we are dust. And to dust, we will return. Paalaala sa atin ng Ebanghelyo ngayon at ng ginawa ni Jesus na pagturo sa lupa, at paalaala ng Kwaresma sa atin, we are dust. Tayo ay lupa. At sa lupa, tayo ay babalik. Yung iba nga buhay pa, amoy lupa na. Hindi naliligo. Regardless of age. So, ligo-ligo din pag may time, no? Para ano, parang gusto niyo nang bumalik sa lupa. Anyway, you know, think about it. The personal concerns and agenda you have right now, it won't matter 5 minutes after we're gone. Malapit na yung election, no? Malamang we can expect a lot of finger pointing and even mudslinging. And who gets caught in the crossfire? Who suffers like the woman caught in adultery, whom the Pharisees and scribes made to stand in the middle of the crowd? Sino ang biktima? Sino ang kawawa? Sino ang naiipit? It is the simple, the hardworking, the innocent, the helpless. Sila yung naiipit at kawawa. at the mercy of selfish leaders and politicians. Sa mga nagtuturoan na ganyan, na nag-aaway, ang kawawa, yung mga maliliit, yung mga pobre, yung mga aba. As the Korean proverb says it, the shrimps die when the whales fight. Yung mga maliliit ang nagiging kawawa. Next Sunday, Palm Sunday. It is also Alay Kapwa Sunday. Let us remember, my dear brothers and sisters, Lent is not just about feeling religious or feeling good. Kapag Kwaresma, maraming tao, ramdam nila, ang bait-bait ko. But Lent is not about that. Just feeling religious and feeling good. Lent, my dear brothers and sisters, is about loving and being good to others. Loving and being good to our brothers and sisters, especially to the little ones and needy. Many people are suffering. God is calling. What are you doing? What are we doing? You know, evil and scheming people thrive and their number grows. Dumadami lalo sila because good people remain quiet and hide. Evil and scheming people in our society will continue to be on a roll as long as the good continue to be timid and uninvolved. Gawa-gawa din ng mabuti. Sabi kasi ng iba, Father, wala naman akong ginagawang masama. That's very good. Kaya lang, may ginagawa ka bang mabuti? My dear brothers and sisters, do not lose sight of our mission. Lagyan natin ng silbi ang ating mga kamay at daliri. This is a mission of every Christian. Why do people lose sight of their mission? Because so many people are too focused on their commissions, too focused on personal ambitions, and most of the time, they are distracted by life's consummation, life's problems. Holy Week na po next week, mga mahal na araw. Stay focused on your mission, my dear brothers and sisters. Let us not use our hands and fingers in accusing, condemning, hurting others. Instead, let us clean our hands and use them to share, reach out, to console. Together we profess our faith. I believe in one God.
The Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
As we draw close to Holy Week and Easter, we beg you, Almighty Father, to sustain us in your divine compassion so that we may attain spiritual renewal as we prepare to accept the Easter mysteries. And we pray, Lord, listen to our prayer.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
By the Spirit of truth, may our church leaders be able to proclaim courageously the gospel even amidst neglect, disinformation, and criticisms. We pray.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
Under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, may our national leaders and citizens vigorously pursue justice for the poor, moral and spiritual renewal, and defend all at cost human life. We pray.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
By the lights of faith, may those who are preparing for baptism be led and directed by their sponsors and catechists towards the steps of Christ, our resurrection and life. We pray.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
As we go through this pandemic, may we courageously witness to Jesus Christ through faith-inspired works of peace, justice, love, and compassion. We pray.
Lord, listen to our prayers.
By the passion and death of Christ, may all the baptized create faith communities that will be rich havens of compassion and love. We pray.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
For peace in the whole world, for the end of the ongoing war between Ukraine and Russia, we likewise pray for our country as we prepare for the coming national and local election. We pray.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
For the souls of Chudora, Tomas, Socorro, Jose, Vicenta, Asuncion, Vicente, Bonifacio, Marcelo Jr., Manuel, Ronald, Emelita, Paul Alfred, Ana Socorro, Attorney Raul, Rolando, Elmer, Innocencio Sr., Floripes, Julio Sr., Concepcion, Helen, Francis Jr., Jose Vicente, Renato, Father Bob Shabo, SSS, Father Muriel Uy, SSS, Dorivic, Norma, Felito Sr., Desiderio Sr., Regina, Desdemona, Vicente Sr., Martha, Evelyn, Catalino, Silvina, Juanita, Alejandro, Irineo, Hermana, Pedro, Constancia, and all souls in purgatory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
Healing and fast recovery of Bel Obrero, Araceli Divina Gracia, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
Special intention of Elson and Vicky Chu, Juan Carlos C. Impas, Michael Raval, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, listen to our prayer.
Thanksgiving of Inc. Book and Civic SCMCI Bookkeeping, Insta Food Services, Fine Dining Davao, One Top Stop Shop. And in silence, let us offer to God our personal and family's intentions.
Father, your word of mercy saved the woman who was condemned to death. By your word, Jesus, save us from death and fill us with life you won for us through his cross. We ask this through the same Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teachings of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of this sacrifice through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, For this is my body, which shall be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Romulo, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
not into temptation,
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Christ who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
let's give peace to one another, and may the Lord be on our side. Ubicaritas et amor, Deus
company of the blessed, we see God's face in glory. Christ pure and abounding joy forever and
let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please kneel together. Let us pray the prayer for the 2022 national and local elections. Let us pray that the forthcoming national and local elections may truly reflect the will of the Lord who guides the destinies of nations. For every petition, let us pray together, deliver us, Lord.
Deliver us, Lord.
From coercion, intimidation, violence, and terrorism.
Deliver us, Lord.
From dishonesty, lies, and all distortion of truth.
Deliver us, Lord.
From bribery, graft, and all conspiracy for fraud.
Deliver us, Lord.
From gullibility to the deceptive and blindness of perspective.
Deliver us, Lord.
From threats, intimidation, and perverse language.
Deliver us, Lord.
Let us pray together. Hear us, Lord.
Hear us, Lord.
That conscience may always be our ultimate norm.
Hear us, Lord.
That the common good may always be our highest goal.
Hear us, Lord.
That human dignity may be respected at all times.
Hear us, Lord.
That the poor and the weak may always have the priority.
Hear us, Lord.
That care for creation may never be ignored.
Hear us, Lord.
That solidarity may guide the path of peace and development.
Hear us, Lord.
That genuine fear of God and love of neighbors may guide those who seek public office.
Hear us, Lord.
Let us pray. Shepherd of souls and Savior of the nations, politics is your gift to us, a call to serve others and grow in holiness. Guide our politics as you guide our lives. May our political engagement for voters and candidates bring glory to your loving name and help us grow in holiness forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the announcement. Our Sunday Gospel Reflection Leaflets are available at the church doors. Please get one copy for family and share. Next Sunday, April 10, is Palm Sunday of the Lord's Passion, the beginning of the Holy Week celebration. The solemn blessing of palms will be at our Mother of Perpetual Help, Jacinto GKK, at 5:30 in the morning. Please be reminded that the blessing of palms in other masses will take place during the entrance procession. Please come on time. Our Holy Week celebration will be live streamed via Our Lady of the Assumption Parish Davao Facebook page. The celebration of the Lord's Supper with washing of the feet on Holy Thursday, April 14, will be at 5 in the afternoon. Immediately, the adoration of the Blessed Sacrament from 7 in the evening until 12 midnight follows. On Good Friday, April 15, the scriptural way of the cross will start at 5:30 in the morning. Assembly place will be here inside the church for the opening prayers, followed by the morning praise. The liturgy of the word, veneration of the cross, and Holy Communion will begin at 3 in the afternoon. There shall be no kissing and touching of the cross and the Santo Entierro. Immediately will follow the procession of the Santo Entierro. On Holy Saturday, April 16, everyone is encouraged to join the morning praise at 7 in the morning, while our Easter Vigil celebration will begin at 7 in the evening. Please bring candles for the services of light and for the renewal of baptismal promises. The Pagsugat or Salubong on Easter Sunday, April 17, will begin at 4:30 in the morning. The assembly areas will be as follows. The Risen Christ will be in front of Central Bank, while our Blessed Mother will be in front of the Bayou Essence along Circumferential Road. The Dawn Mass of Easter shall follow immediately. We shall follow our regular Sunday Mass schedule, except that there will be no Mass at 6 in the morning. Our Holy Week celebrations will still follow our health protocols. All churchgoers must wear face masks and shall observe social distancing. Our complete Holy Week schedule will be posted in our Facebook page. Since the church is the house of God and the place of worship, everyone is encouraged to wear appropriate clothes and observe proper behavior as a sign of deep respect for the holy sacrifice of the Mass and for complete, active, and conscious participation in liturgy. Please be reminded that this Mass promptly begins at 8 a.m. Please come on time.
Maraming salamat po sa lahat ng naglingkod sa ating misa ngayong umaga, sa ating commentators, sa ating mga lectors na magre-renew mamayang alas tres, sa ating mga lay ministers, sa ating mga ushers and greeters, sa ating magaling na choir, thank you very much, sa ating sakristan, at sa ating media ministry, si Brother Pao, na nagbibilang na ng kanilang mga huling sandali dito sa Davao, sila ay aalis na sa April 20. Masaya sila. Masaya din kami. So, it's a tie. So, ilang araw na lang ba yan? 18, 17. So, enjoy your remaining stay here in Davao. Yun lang. And please all stand. Let us continue to use our hands not in pointing and accusing, but in loving and doing good to others. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
He'll tell us what to do. It's the time to change ourselves and show the world that we still truly care for our fellow men. We lead them to a place beyond the sea, a place of love.